Today we're going to talk about the simple switch end stop for the MakerBase MKS S Gen L version 1.0. So first I need to review where our end stops are. So we have our X minimum, our X maximum, our Y minimum, our Y max, our Z minimum, and our Z max. Now the pins, as they're configured, are a little bit different. So the very top pin for each one of these is gonna be 5 volts. The middle pin for each one of these is gonna be ground. And the pin below the ground is gonna be your signal pin for each one of these end stops. So with the simple end stop switch that we have here, I need to tell you a little bit about it. It basically creates a connection when the switch is depressed. And so there's two wires that you're going to be using for this. The black is going to be ground in this case. And for this instance, we're going to use the red as our signal. Don't use it as your voltage because you'll damage your board. So remember, the red is signal and the black is ground. So in order to connect this to the X minimum, we need to flip it over so that we have it in the correct position and then slide it right in like so. Noting that the voltage pin is not connected, we're only connecting the ground and the signal wire. So to program this, what we need to do is connect the big side of the USB to our board. And we need to connect the small side to our computer, and you're probably going to hear a beep. So to start with, I want to show you the pinout diagram once again. This is on the website up above. I'll include a link in the description for you. Now, as you can see, you have your X minimum, your X max, your Y minimum, your Y max, your Z minimum, and your Z max. Now, like I said, it was 5 volts for the top pin, ground in the center, and then your signal pin. That'll be the same for every one of these, except the signal pin number will change because it's the signal pin. So let's go over to the Marlin website. It's marlinfw.org and press enter. Now we're going to go to download. And in download, what we're going to do is we're going to download the bug fix. So I'm going to click on bug fix and this is going to download it for us. Now keep in mind, no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do tutorials on this, and I purchased this with my own money, but I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. Now let's open up where it is in the folder and right click on it and extract all and click extract. Now if you don't already know, the initial tutorial for basics, I showed you how to install VS Code with Platform IO as a plugin. If you're unsure of how to do that, check out the basics tutorial. So in a second, what we'll do is we'll actually open up VS Code and see what we can do. So to do this, I'm going to type down here VS to prep it. And you can see it's Visual Studio Code. And this will have the plugin for Platform IO already loaded on it. So here we go. Inside here, we have a bunch of things that are already open. I'm going to close them for a second. And I'm going to scroll up and close this down a little bit so that we can work with it. So I'm going to go to the source folder, then the core folder, and then boards.h. Inside here, I'm going to do a search on MKS S Gen which appears not to show up, so I'm going to remove the MKS and do SGen underscore L. And that apparently doesn't show up either. So we're going to scroll around and find it here. So it looks like I may be searching for a moment here, but we'll see what we can find. So we have the MKS GenL here. So let's try doing a search on MKS SGenL. And there it is. So I'm going to double click on this to copy it. And copy it with a right click under copy. So I'm going to reduce the core folder down. Now the source. And I'm going to close out of boards.h. Now I'm going to go to configuration.h. And I'm going to scroll up to the top. And I'm going to do a search on motherboard. And what we're going to do is we're going to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB and paste what we just copied. Then I'm going to scroll up and I'm going to change the serial port to -1. And now we're going to do a search on end stops. So I'm going to do end stop. And this brings us to the end stop section. And as you can see right now, we only have 3 end stops for minimum enabled. So if you were to enable the other ones, which you don't need, you would remove the comment. But keep in mind, you only need 1 direction for your end stops, and that's going to be minimum in this case. Now, in this case, we're using a simple end stop that doesn't have any electronics on it. It just makes a connection. So we don't have to worry about a capacitor or a resistor for the end stops pull up or for the pull down. But in this case, we do at times need to worry about inverting. And what this does is it reverses the logic of the end stop in the Marlin firmware. For instance, if it says open when you do the G code for M119, and you actually want it to say triggered, you would change the false to a true. But in this case, we don't need to do that, so we're going to skip that. Now what we need to do is we need to figure out for platform IO, what we're going to set for our default environment. Now, I'm not sure what it is off the top of my head because it's been a while since I've read about this board. So I'm going to go to the source folder. Then I'm going to go to the pins folder. And I suspect that it's an LPC 1768. So I'm going to click here and I'm going to look for the MKS SGenL, which it is present. So we know that it's going to be LPC 1768. So now that we have that set, we're going to click on the upload button. What will occur is it will do a build or a compile, and then it will upload to our board. So let me show you the actual SD card that shows up. So first, when we connected the serial cable to this board, we had a USB drive appear which says firmware. So this is actually the drive to our MKS SGenL version 1.0. So when we click on upload, it should send the file there. So let's see what happens. Okay, now that the build has completed, as you can see up here, it says that it's successful. So let's check to see what it looks like on the USB drive. And as you can see, it says firmware.bin. To load this, what we're going to do is we're going to remove the USB for a moment. Then we're going to plug it back in. And as you can see, it's updated the firmware to the current time. So I'm going to close out of here and show you in Pronterface how this works. So we're going to go to our desktop here where I have print run loaded. And I'm going to start Prawner Face. Now I'm going to connect to the MKS S-Gen L. And as you can see, it says connecting and printer is now online. So I'm going to first type M119 for the G code, press send, see what it looks like. And right now it says the X minimum is open. So I'm going to click it with my finger here. And I'm going to do another send. And now it says triggered. So I'm going to remove my finger. And I'm going to do the send one more time. And now it says open. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.